Hello there, my name is Joshua Harris, I'm head of support at Parseur. In this video, we're going to go over how to parse complex PDFs and make that data available as a directly downloadable Excel file. Right now, we're looking at the first thing you see when creating an account. This is the mailbox creation screen. We organize all of our documents into buckets, so all of your invoices go into one mailbox, your bank statements go into another, purchase orders, and so on and so forth. So I have a couple of sample documents. I have three different bank statements of varying formats we're going to send in here. And the AI will automatically look for and extract any obvious key value pairs and table data that's in this document. So it takes just a few seconds. On the right side of our screen is the mailbox navigation. Home is where you can go to your other mailboxes. Dashboard will show you information about your current mailbox that you're looking at and the current settings. Upload and import screen will show you your automatic email forwarding email that you can use, and you can drag and drop here. There's also instructions on how to use the other methods of import. And the documents tab is where you're going to be spending most of your time. This is going to be a searchable database of your documents that you've uploaded. The fields tab, this is where the AI has generated instructions to extract your data, and we can also easily edit and add instructions here as well. So the documents have already processed, so let's go have a look. We can see over here on the right side, this data field, or this data column rather, or tab, is where we can see the output that the AI has generated. And then on the fields tab here, we can see the instructions again. It's the same as this tab here, but we can look at the document and change the instructions at the same time. So we see the header data is being extracted, and we can also see the transactions are also being accurately extracted. So this looks really good. Let's have a look at some of the other bank statements. We can toggle between them and see that account name, account number, all of that stuff is still being extracted. The transactions are being extracted properly. Account name, account number on this last document. So as you can see, we have different formats coming in, and the AI is able to still be able to tell even if the column says money in, money out, you know, we have deposits and withdrawals being properly put into their own columns here. But let's say, for example, I want to change some of this output. We can see in this account number here, we have some hyphens. For learning purposes, let's say in my download, I don't want to have any hyphens. We can really easily go to the fields tab, go to account number, and say remove any hyphens in the number, and hit update. Another thing that I might want to change is I can see statement period is being captured with two long form dates. Maybe I'd like a from to dates captured as different fields in a machine readable format. We can delete this field, and we're going to create two new ones. We'll say date from. Set the output format to date, and then date to, output format to date. And this is going to automatically format the output, so it's not going to return July 3, 2008. We'll see 07/03/2018. All right, so we've changed the way that we want the account number to return. We want to remove those hyphens. We've also changed the way that we want these dates to return. We want to get machine readable dates, and so we've done that by creating two different date fields. You can see the date of the transactions. We also would like to normalize those if possible, so we want to edit that date, change the output format for that as date as well. We have a few other options just to show you. One of the more common output formatting options that customers go for is the address field. If we need to normalize or validate a address that you have in your system, we can run that across Google Maps API, is what that actually plugs into, and we'll give you quite a few columns of that address data validated and broken down for you. So a couple of different other options for formatting your output there. But we've made a few changes, and let's go ahead and reprocess all of these documents. We can do that by going to the Documents tab, selecting all, clicking Reprocess. This should take just a few seconds, and we're going to see pretty quickly. I wanted to go to this one. We can see that the hyphens were removed from the account number, and that we are capturing from date from and date to dates with machine readable text. And we're seeing that that is being consistently extracted across all three of our bank statements. So this is looking really good. As far as download and export is concerned, we generate XLS, CSV, and JSON downloads by default. Let's have a look at just what that looks like right now. Across those three bank statements, we're getting really nice uniform data. We can see the date from, date to, the balance, description, the date withdrawn, deposit. We can see these are a little bit out of order. So what we can do here is we can create a new download. And while in our system, in the fields tab, the fields are locked to alphabetical order, you can change them around here in our system. So we can move the balance to the end, just make it look like the rest of the like the rest of the documents. Just leave it that way. Hit create document, download this, and this is immediately available. And so now we have the transaction data organized the way that it actually looks like in the document, with the dates, description, withdrawal, deposits, and the balance there. So other options of export, we plug into integration platforms like Zapier, Power Automate, and Make to complete your automation workflow if you already have one that's existing. We have Google Sheets. We have a formula that you can paste into a Google Sheet where you can have a live updated, look at your spreadsheet that's updated every hour or so. And then lastly, if you have developer resources available, you can build out a webhook to your third-party endpoint. And we have a few different controls depending on how the processing goes. If there's an issue with the webhook, we can send a different webhook out to you to notify you, a couple of different things like that. So that's really most of the basics of our service. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us at support@parseur.com. Also, when you create an account, there is a chat widget at the bottom right corner of the screen. Finn will pull from our knowledge base, but you can just say talk to a person and it'll put you in our queue and we can help you out. So it's been a pleasure speaking to you. Have a wonderful day.